Hi students,
I welcome you all to English class. Today's class is describing words, chapter 6, unit 2, listening. The word adjective literally means added to. In adjective, such a word is added to the noun to describe or point out the person, animal, place, or thing, to tell the number, quality, or the quantity. So, an adjective describes or points out a noun. Examples. Hari is a good boy. Sita is a bad girl. That is a clever cat. That is a foolish fox. Delhi is a big city. So, answer the following questions in a word or two. Is your friend tall or short? Suppose your friend is tall, tell yes, my friend is tall. Suppose your friend is short, say your friend is short. Okay, next. How else does your friend look? He looks handsome. He looks ugly. Whatever it is. Next. What sort of person is he or she? Is a good person? Is a bad person? Is a sincere person? What kind of person? Okay. Read the following paragraph and state what it is about. The main idea of the paragraph, what it is. Lavanya is a tall, slim woman in her early 20s. She has got thick black hair and brown eyes. She usually wears traditional Indian clothes. She is very shy. For instance, she finds it very difficult to make new friends. Now tell me, question, what is the paragraph about? Okay, in my answer, the model answer is description of Lavanya. It is about Lavanya. Okay, now read the paragraph again and note in the boxes the describing words. Just now I answered what is the paragraph about. I told description of Lavanya, describing about Lavanya. Now you have to identify the describing words, how Lavanya is described in the paragraph, how Lavanya is compared or described. I will give one example. Tall. Lavanya is a tall. Next, slim woman. Slim also describing word, slim. Next, black hair. Next, brown eyes. Black, brown. She is very shy. So in that way. Some are shy. Next. Okay. Now, write words that mean the opposite for each word listed above. I just told you tall. What is the opposite word of tall? Short. Next, I told you slim. What is the opposite word of slim? Fat. Okay. suppose black, white, we cannot say brown, okay? Shy, shy, opposite, bold, strong. Okay. Next, brainstorm for words that can be used to describe people. Brainstorm means thinking, be in depth. That can be used to describe people. How generally we describe people? What kind of words we use to describe people? How many kinds of people generally we see? How the people appear? So that is the question. So words often used to describe people: tall person, short person, fat person, thin person, slim person, black person, white person. In that way, there are so many words are there. Not only a physical appearance, inside mentality also important. So what kind of words generally we use? Arrogant, sincere. So I have given some model words, describing words for people. So here, see, model answers: large, wise, beautiful, energetic. Energetic means very powerful. Brave means strong. Funny, misery, win, lose, simple, silent, fast, small, arrogant, bad, young, rich, fit, kind, better, sweet, compare, dead, active. Okay, next activity, that is activity one. Imagine that you are standing outside a bank and you see this man running out. See, this man is running out from the bank. Who do you think the man could be? Describe him. Okay, definitely we can say he is a burglar. Am I right? Thief. Because he concealed his eyes. He is, he has a mask. Next, he's a bag. A lot of money is there. So he is a thief, burglar. So how is this man? Is he small, thin? No, he's very strong. Okay, right. The man in the picture was burglar. He is a fat man. And he is a burglar with a huge amount on his back. He wears a full black dress as well as black goggles. He has a bald head. He is a strong man with a cruel face. Okay. Now, note the words used to describe this man. So what kind of words I have used here? Burglar, fat man, huge amount is a description of amount, money. Okay, leave it. Next, wears full black dress, black goggles, bald hair, strong man, cruel face. So, fat, huge, black, bald, strong, cruel. Okay, these are the words used to describe the man. Now, listen something related to this topic only. Okay, then you have to say, what is this story about? Who is the person? What happened there? Everything. Now, ready. There were five men. The first was tall and thin. He had a square face with blue eyes and curly fair hair. The second was short and fat with a roundish face and short, straight, dark hair. The third was of medium build. I didn't see his face, but he had longish dark hair. The fourth man was quite thin, medium height. He had a long, thin face with a big nose. His hair was dark and curly, and he had a mustache and a beard. The last man was short and clumpish, with very short blonde hair. I didn't see his face, but I remember his ears. They were very big. Okay. What do you think it is about? Yes, the description of the burglars. Five burglars. Robbers. In other words, bank robbers. Okay. Next. Listen to the statement given by a woman, a witness, as read out by your teacher. Understand what you are listening to. That means the main idea. Note that in the bubble. You have to identify what are the features explained in the audio. Okay. Now begin once again.
There were five men. The first was tall and thin. He had a square face with blue eyes and curly fair hair. The second was short and fat with a roundish face and short, straight, dark hair. The third was of medium build. I didn't see his face, but he had longish dark hair. The fourth man was quite thin, medium height. He had a long, thin face with a big nose. His hair was dark and curly, and he had a mustache and a beard. The last man was short and clumpish, with very short blonde hair. I didn't see his face, but I remember his ears. They were very big.
Okay. So, you have to write the main idea. What you understood. What you have listened. You have to write it. How many burglars are, robbers are there? How the robbers are there? Which robber has which kind of specialty? Any peculiarity? Are they similar? Are they different? So you have to write. Okay. Now listen to the statement given by woman again for a specific information and answer the following questions.
There were five men. The first was tall and thin. He had a square face with blue eyes and curly fair hair. The second was short and fat with a roundish face and short, straight, dark hair. The third was of medium build. I didn't see his face, but he had longish dark hair. The fourth man was quite thin, medium height. He had a long, thin face with a big nose. His hair was dark and curly, and he had a mustache and a beard. The last man was short and clumpish, with very short blonde hair. I didn't see his face, but I remember his ears. They were very big.
Okay. How many men were there? How many robbers participated in the robbery? Next, how many were thin? How many had dark hair? How many had big ears? So you have to answer them. Okay, listen it once again and I'll write the answers. Okay, next. Listen to the statement given by woman once again and note the words that describe each person in detail. Statement by a person who saw the robbers. First person details, second person details, third person details, fourth person details, fifth person details.
There were five men. The first was tall and thin. He had a square face with blue eyes and curly pale hair. The second was short and fat with a roundish face and short straight dark hair. The third was of medium build. I didn't see his face, but he had longish dark hair. The fourth man was quite thin, medium height. He had a long, thin face with a big nose. His hair was dark and curly, and he had a mustache and a beard. The last man was short and plumpish, with very short blonde hair. I didn't see his face, but I remember his ears. They were very big.
Okay, write them all specific details of the five robbers in your notebook. Now, arrange the pictures of the five people in the order in which they appear in the passage from what you heard. A, B, C, D, E. So there are five robbers. So which one is the first robber? Which was when the second thief? Which one is third thief? So which picture suitable to which robber? So you have to identify them and write. Next, read the statement given by a woman to check your answers. So far you have practiced activity. So your activity answers are right or wrong, check here. There were five men. The first was tall and thin. He had a square face with blue eyes and curly fair hair. The second was short and fat with a roundish face and short straight dark hair. The third was of medium build. I didn't see his face, but he had longish dark hair. The fourth man was quite thin, medium height. He had a long thin face with a big nose. His hair was dark and curly, and he had a mustache and beard. The last man was short and plumpish with very short blonde hair. I didn't see his face, but I remember his ears. They were very big. Now, activity two. What are the words that describe people or things called? What are the words that describe people? Are things called describing words? None other than describing words, also called adjectives. They describe the noun. Okay. Check your answers with the following definition and note the examples that follow. Okay. An adjective is a word used with a noun or a pronoun to add something to its meaning. Usually, it is placed before a noun or after a verb in a sentence. adjectives are used before noun or after verb. Okay. Example, the lazy student was punished. Here student is noun. So lazy is adjective. The lazy student was punished. Next, the student is lazy. Is verb. Is verb. So it was lazy is written after verb. The student is lazy. Next, select suitable adjectives from the box and fill in the blanks. Here heavy, neither. Heavy means very the weight is more. Neither means nothing, nobody. Faithful, you know, few, red, cold, several, every, great, hearty, long, glorious, second, small, royal. Glorious means high, very name. Especially royal related, kings, glorifying. Is glorifying is qualities. Suppose Akbar, how is the person, how king, his battles, his rule, like that. The car sustained dash damage in the accident. He has written dash stories. A dog is very dash to its master. Dash man has his duties. He is a man of dash words. Dash party is unique in the right. I like a dash shirt. The way was dash. The wind was dash. John won the dash prize. Abhimanyu died dash death. A dash leak is enough to sink a dash ship. King Francis was dash king and loved dash sports. Okay, you have to fill the correct answer. Okay, I have given answers here. Check with them. First one is heavy. The car sustained heavy damage. Next, he has written dash stories. Dash stories means several stories. Next, a dog is very dash to its master. Generally, dog is faithful animal, you know. Dash man has duties. Which man has duties? Every man has his duties. He is a man of dash. Man of few words. He doesn't speak more. He works hard. Next, in that way, you have to fill it. Next, on completion of the above activity, you have seen that there are different kinds of adjectives or describing words. Okay, different kinds of adjectives and describing words. Categorize the adjectives given in the box by identifying the common features and list them below. So which are common, which are not common, which are same, which are not same, you have to identify them. So adjectives are different. Adjectives related to number, adjectives related to quality, adjectives related to color, adjectives related to quantity. In that way, there are different kinds of adjectives are there, describing words are there. Yeah, we have to categorize them. How many kinds of adjectives are there? So generally, adjectives are two kinds. Descriptive adjectives quantity adjectives. What are descriptive adjectives? Descriptive adjectives are related to quality, size, color. Quantity adjectives are amount, number. Quantity is amount, number. Descriptive means quality, size, color. So, examples, quality examples. These examples are taken from these answers. Okay. Heavy, neither, faithful, few, red, cold, several, every, great, hearty, long, like that. So, quality related words are faithful is quality, cold, quality, great, quality, royal, quality, glorious, quality, hearty, quality. Next, size, small, long, heavy. Color, red. Next, quantity, neither. Quantity, how many present? Neither present. 20 members present. 30 members present. 1,000 present. Okay, either. Neither. These are quantity. Amount, neither, second, every, like that. Next, number. Few, several. So, for some more information regarding adjectives, please refer your dictionaries, whatever the books, grammar-related books you have, refer them and learn some more information. I will prepare one more special video on these adjectives. Okay. First of all, we shall continue. We shall finish in this video only our chapter. After that, I will prepare separate video on adjective, complete adjectives. So here, generally we see numbers 1, 2, 3, sometimes 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th. So they have some, they have a specific name. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this kind of numbers are called. These are called cardinal numbers. First, second, third numbers are called ordinal numbers. Next, activity 3. Note down the adjectives as your teacher reads out a passage. Okay, after listening the passage or while listening the passage, you have to note down the adjectives. Okay?
Reading makes a full man, writing an exact and conference a ready man. Studies serve for delight, for ornament, and for ability. Some books are to be tasted, others are to swallow, and still others are to be digested. Books give comfort not only in happiness, but even in sorrow. We are indebted a lot to the books. The amount of satisfaction we derive by reading a book cannot be estimated in terms of monetary value. It is inexplicable and indescribable. It is subjective, and we can only feel it.
So, in your examination point of view, generally they give a paragraph, and you have to do is you have to identify the adjectives and write down in the answer booklet. So it's very important. Here I have given audio clip, but in your examination they give paragraph. In that paragraph you have to identify the adjectives and write down. Okay, I have given some modal answers, full, delight, ability. Some more are there. You have to listen it again and write down the answers.
Reading way.
Next, activity 4. Read the passage and fill in the blanks with appropriate adjectives from the choices given below. So Raju is a dashboard. who always stands first in the class. The teachers like him for being dash in the class. His classmates adore him because he is dash. Adore means like, okay. He is a dash, but he is a dash. So every dash you have four choices, okay? Raju is a dash boy. Raju is a dash boy. See, dull boy, passive boy, bright boy, arrogant boy. We cannot say here exact right answer because we, if we go further, we can identify what kind of person is he. So better stop here. Don't write answers here. Don't confirm to one conclusion answer. So the teachers like him. Teachers like him. Definitely teachers like the bright student, not dull, passive, arrogant student. So definitely answer is bright student. Here the answer is bright student. So teachers like him for being dash in the class. Obedient, careless, reckless, nervous. Nervous means tension person. Reckless means not concentrating on the subject, chapter. Reckless, not interested person. Careless, yes, same, equal meaning. Obedience means the person who obeys orders, the person who obeys whatever the teacher says, does everything. So the right answer is obedient. Next, third one. His classmates adore him. Classmates love him. Because he is dash, because he is poor, because of poor poverty, they like no, polite, rich, courteous. Polite and courteous are similar. So take the word polite. Polite means obedient, mariyada, courteous is also one. Generally, it has the more weightage, polite, being polite. Next, he is a dash, but he is a dash. Then we jumped, I think, sorry. His classmates adore him because he is industrious, lazy, haughty, industrious, irresponsible. So industrious means hardworking person. So everybody likes in the hardworking person. So the answer is industrious. Next, fourth one is dash, but he is dash. He is a poor or he is a rich. He is a rich. He is rich. Because how we can say he is rich? Because he is humble. Humble means obedient. Though he is rich, definitely poor people humble. Poor people will be humble. They will not be any reckless, impolite, rash. They won't be. So though he is rich, he is humble is right. Combination. Okay. Next. Adjectives, additional information. Generally, what kind of common errors, mistakes generally we do? Common errors in the use of adjectives. Double comparative or double superlative is not used. Generally, one word is enough. Double comparison should not be written. Example, she is more taller than her sister. Taller is comparative adjective. If we are not able to write comparative adjective, then we take the help of more. So here taller is itself compared to. So we have to omit, delete more. So She is taller than her sister is right. Next. Stein is the most fastest bowler in the world. Fastest itself says the superlative quality. Degree. Most is not necessary. If the adjective does not convey, if we cannot write the adjective in the superlative form, we take the help most. But here the word itself shows fast superlative quality. So we have to remove it. Stein is the fastest bowler in the world. So that is called double comparative or double superlative adjective. Okay. Next. Adjectives like superior, inferior, junior, senior take the preposition to after them, not than. Generally, we commit mistake writing than, but that is wrong. If the word is superior, inferior, junior, senior comes, you have to write preposition to, not than. So see, Gopi is senior than me by 5 years. Wrong. Gopi is senior to me by 5 years is right. Okay. Next. This machine is superior than that. Wrong. This machine is superior to that is right. Next. Some is used in affirmative sentences. Any conveys negative meaning. Any means nothing. Is there any person means any? Nobody is there now. Like that. Some is definitely something is there. Somebody is there. Is there some sugar? Is there some sugar? That means actually he wants to ask, is there nothing sugar now? Nothing sugar now. Sugar is nothing there now. He wants to ask. So here, is there any sugar is important. Next. Many takes a plural verb, whereas many a takes a singular verb. Many takes a plural verb, whereas many a takes singular verb. Many a student have appeared for the test. Many a is singular, just now I explained. So the helping word must be in singular form. So see, has, many a student has. Next, elder. Elder means the superior person in the family or the caste or the society or a village. Older means age, in age is superior. So she is my older sister. Pedda. Pedda annapudu elder. Okay. So she is my elder sister. When you want to convey the information with the age related, vice 95 years, 20 years, age is mentioned, definitely you have to take older. Next, when a comparison is between two persons, places, or things, adjective is not used in the superlative degree. Comparative degree is used. If the more than two are there, then only superlative degree comes. If the comparative things are only two, we should not write superlative degree. So this is the best of the two. Wrong. This is the better of the two. Superlative degree is used only when we refer to three or more than three persons, places, or things only. Next, seventh one. Some adjectives like unique, ideal, round, perfect, eternal have superlative sense. The word itself superlative. So they have no degree of comparison. we should not write an again compare to and superlative, positive. No, there is nothing. The word itself superlative. Example. See, it is the most perfect example of commitment. Perfect means perfect. Finish. Okay? It is a perfect example of commitment. Next, look at the following sentence. The price of gold is more expensive than silver. The price of gold is more expensive than that of silver. Here, comparison. Compared to the same equal thing only. When a singular noun is used to compare, we use than that of. In case of plural, we use than those of. So the price here, the first sentence, the price of gold is more expensive than silver. So gold, you are comparing. So definitely you have to use the price of gold is more expensive than that of silver. If it is plural, than those of, you have to use. Next, further means beyond or additional, extra, further means. Further means long distance, somewhere distance. He went abroad for further studies. No, further studies, some more additional. Next, when both is used as an adjective, definite article the is used. Both is used as an adjective. If you use both as an adjective, we have to add the article. See example. We were present on both days. Both here is adjective. So we were present on both the days is right answer. Next, adjective, activity 5. Correct the following sentences. Mount Everest is the most highest peak in the world. Just now we explained. Double adjective. Okay. Highest already explaining. So Mount Everest is the highest peak in the world. Next, the elephants of India are more graceful than South Africa. Here we have to compare elephants to elephants. Okay. The elephants of India are more graceful than elephants, is plural, so than those of South Africa. Next. Lata is seen junior than me. Just I explained. Junior to me. Many a teacher have ennobled the profession. Many a teacher is singular. So has ennobled the profession. He is elder than by me 5 years. If that age is mentioned, use older. He is older than me by 5 years. It is the most unique opportunity for the Indians. Unique is unique. Nothing, no superlative. So it is unique opportunity is enough. The blue pen is the most expensive of the two. Two, only two is there. So no superlative. The blue pen is more expensive than of the two. Next, they did not go any further in the forest. Further means further studies. Not a distance. So they did not go any farther in the forest is right answer. Next, Mount Everest is the highest peak in the world. So right, these are the answers, okay. Next, study them, identify the correct answer, okay. If you did not know answer, okay, I have given answers also here. Okay, next assignment. Describe your classmate using as many adjectives as possible. Okay, your friend also, take any friend. How is the person? Describe. Yeah, I have given some model description. So you have to write in the same way. Model, this is model. In that similar way. Okay, I hope you all understood the lesson. Further anything, you have any doubts, we can clarify in the live session. So until then, listen carefully, practice it, write the activities in your notebook. So we shall meet in the class, live class soon. Okay, thank you.